Peru is a country of history, culture, beauty, and adventure, with a full spectrum of possibilities for everyone who wishes to visit this marvelous country. With landscapes ranging from mountains, deserts, and jungle to sea, Peru's uniqueness is spot on. Let us take a long trip and discover Peru's geographical, historical, cultural, and political features. The country of Peru is the third largest country in South America, after Brazil and Argentina. It is located in the western part of South America. It stretches along the Pacific Ocean and shares a border with five other countries: Ecuador and Colombia to the north, Brazil to the east, Bolivia to the southeast, and Chile to the south. Peru's geography can be divided into three major regions: the Andes in the central part of the country, the coastal region in the west, and the Amazon in the east. The people of Peru are a mix of many different cultures, including Indians, Spaniards, and other Europeans, descendants of African slaves, and Asians. Until recently, most people lived in the countryside. Peru's Andes Mountains, arid deserts, Amazon jungle, and Pacific coast each produced distinct civilizations, dating back to the prehistoric era. Most Peruvians have at least some indigenous ancestry. Today, Peru has a population of around 30 million. Most people are Spanish-speaking and Catholic, part of the culture shaped by the Spanish colonial power that lasted from the mid-16th century until 1824. While most Peruvians speak Spanish, Highlanders are more likely to also speak Quechua, the language of the Inca. Over the centuries, indigenous religious practices and Catholicism blended together. You can see the results of this mixture at one of the many religious festivals celebrated throughout the year, especially in Cusco. The first national flag of Peru was created in 1820, when José de San Martín arrived with his army of the Andes from Argentina and Chile. The Peruvian flag he designed combined the colors red and white, said to have been chosen because San Martín saw a flock of flamingos take wing at his arrival. On February 25, 1825, the design now in use was established, but the sun was replaced by a new coat of arms. Its shield is framed by one wreath of palm and laurel branches, and surmounted by another. The shield is divided into three parts with figures symbolic of national pride and wealth. The vicuña, a free-roaming camelid closely related to the llama and alpaca, is represented in the first quartering. In addition to representing the riches of Peruvian fauna, it stands for freedom, national pride, and heroism. The second quartering has a cinchona tree, the bark of which is used to make quinine. Finally, the bottom half of the shield displays a cornucopia from which spill gold and silver coins, symbolic of the nation's mineral wealth. In addition, the white stripe of the flag is said to represent purity, and the red recalls the blood of patriots. The politics of the Republic of Peru takes place in a framework of a unitary semi-presidential representative democratic republic, in which the central government holds the most power and can create administrative divisions. The Peruvian system of government combines elements derived from Western and Asian political systems such as the United States, a written constitution, an autonomous Supreme Court, and a presidential system, and the People's Republic of China, a unicameral Congress, a premier and ministry system. The Constitution of Peru is the supreme law of Peru. The current constitution, enacted on the 31st of December 1993, is Peru's fifth in the 20th century and replaced the 1979 constitution. The constitution was drafted by the Democratic Constituent Congress that was convened by President Alberto Fujimori during the Peruvian constitutional crisis of 1992 that followed his 1992 dissolution of Congress, was promulgated on the 29th of December 1993. The current constitution of Peru differs from the 1979 constitution in that it gives greater power to the president. For example, it allowed for re-election, reduced the bicameral 240-member Congress to a unicameral 120 Congress of the Republic, not only affirmed the president's power to veto found in the 1979 constitution, but also gave him the power to use a line-item veto, and mandated that all tax laws receive prior approval by the Ministry of Economics and Finance. The Peruvian government is separated into three branches. The executive branch, which consists of the president, the Council of Ministers, which in practice controls domestic legislation and served as a cabinet to the president, consisting of the prime minister and 18 ministers of the state. Under its constitution, the president of Peru is both head of state and government and is elected to a 5-year term without immediate re-election. The president appoints the prime minister, primer ministro, and the council of ministers, consejo de ministros, our cabinet, which is individually and collectively responsible both to the president and the legislature. All presidential decree laws or draft bills sent to Congress must be approved by the council of ministers. The legislature branch, which consists of the unicameral Congress of Peru, consisting of 130 members of Congress, on a basis of population, the President of Congress, and the Permanent Commission, elected for a 5-year term by proportional representation in addition to passing laws. The Congress ratifies treaties, authorizes government loans, and approves the government budget. The President has the power to block legislation with which the executive branch does not agree. The judiciary branch, which consists of the Supreme Court of Peru, also known as the Royal Audiencia of Lima, is the branch of the government of Peru that interprets and applies the laws of Peru to ensure equal justice under law and provide a mechanism for dispute resolution. Peru's electoral system uses compulsory voting for citizens from the age of 18 to 70, including dual citizens and Peruvians abroad. Constituents in respective districts through proportional voting directly elect members of Congress. The president is elected in a general election, along with the vice president, through a majority in a 2-round system. Elections are observed and organized by the National Jury of Elections, National Office of Electoral Processes, and the National Registry of Identification and Civil Status. Under the 2-round election system, the election process usually proceeds to a second round only if in the first round no candidate received a simple majority, more than 50%, of votes cast, or some other lower prescribed percentage. Under the 2-round system, usually only the two candidates who received the most votes in the first round, or only those candidates who received above a prescribed proportion of the votes, are candidates in the second round. Other candidates are excluded from the second round. For administrative purposes, the country is divided into 25 regions, which are further divided into departments, provinces, and districts. The regional level of government encompasses regions and departments, provinces, districts, and smaller population centers constitute the levels of local government. Peru uses a multi-party system for congressional and general elections. Major groups that have formed governments, both on a federal and legislative level, are parties that have historically adopted economic liberalism, progressivism, right-wing populism, specifically Fujimorism, nationalism, and reformism. A wide spectrum of political parties, ranging from right-wing conservative to left-wing socialist and communist, participate in the political process, including the Nationalist Party United Peru, left-wing, the Peruvian Aprista Party, formerly left-wing but now moderate center, and National Unity, right-wing. Traditional parties have been supplanted in many elections by hastily formed coalitions. For example, the winner of the 1990 presidential contest, Alberto Fujimori, created a new party expressly for that election. A law passed in 2003 requires that women constitute at least 30% of all candidates on party lists. In the early 21st century, women held slightly more than 1/4 of the seats in Congress. The most recent general election, the 2021 Peruvian general election, was held on the 11th of April 2021, to elect the President of the Republic of Peru, two vice presidents of the same party, 130 congressmen of the Congress of Peru and 5 Andean parliamentarians for a 5-year term from 2021 to 2026. Later on, the next general elections are to be held in Peru in April 2026. The most current general election resulted in Free Peru party system winning the most seats in Congress, although it fell well short of a majority. A presidential two-way system between Pedro Castillo and Keiko Fujimori took place on the 5th of June 2021 and resulted in the victory of Castillo as the new head of state of Peru.
A former teacher who gained attention during the 2017 teacher strike, Pedro Castillo, is the left-wing contender. He's a candidate representing a new party called Free Peru, and he was able to pass the election's first round with only 19% of the vote. He advocates for widespread nationalization policies and promises a new people's constitution.
I give an oath from my heart for a true democracy, for equality in rights and opportunities for the people of Peru, without discrimination and without privilege.
Pedro Castillo is a former Ronda campesina that defended rural areas from the Shining Path in the 1980s, and a politician with the center-left party Possible Peru from 2002 to 2017. Castillo gained attention in 2017, as he led multiple teacher strikes in five regions against Pedro Pablo Kaczynski's administration.
On Sunday, many in Peru will believe they've either elected a criminal or a communist, but whoever takes charge, they'll have the unenviable task of running a country mired in corruption, poverty, an economic downturn, and as of this week, the world's worst death rate from COVID-19.